Hello and welcome to the evolution of skilling. This video will go over changes in the evolution of combat which will benefit skillers in the long run and aid them, giving them more experience per hour. First off, we have an inventory and my action bar open, and in the inventory we have Arctic Pine Logs, mentioned as one of the fastest experience rates in game at previous times already, and we're going to power drop them, but do note that their left click is light. But before I go any further and go ahead and drop them, I do have them bound to two keys in my action bar only because it's quicker dropping, and since the left click is light, you might accidentally mishit the key and you will end up lighting one, then you have to take a step over and then drop them again. So let's go ahead and do this. And boom, dropped in lickety split time. So that was just, that's woodcutting with just Arctic Pine Logs. And there's multiple skills such as fishing, mining, fire, and other stuff that can actually really do some great things like that. So I'll see you with this next part, and it'll be over fishing. So I'll see you right there. And we're back. We're on the side of the River Shiloh inside the Shiloh village. And as you see, I've got trout and salmon in my inventory. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to power drop them right now, and I'm going to show you something interesting afterwards. So instead of, as you know, you can mine, or you have to stop in fishing when you drop something. Well, in this case you don't have to. You can actually just say click it, and you'll still keep fishing. You'll never stop fishing when you do it, unless, you know, the lure or the fishing spot that you're at actually despawns. So I mean, it's nothing major, but it's definitely interesting to say the least. And it can just, and somebody else made a video over this, something in this category already, saying you can get up to like say 70k XP an hour doing this versus the old way, which is like 35k. So it effectively doubles your experience per hour. So next part we'll be going over craft or fletching, I should say, and I'll see you there. And we're back, and I have an inventory of magic logs this time, and what I'm going to go over is fletching and bonfire making, or even just regular fire making in the EoC using the new Make X interface and the action bar. So I just click on this, and it pops up choose the tool, which is the Make X interface, and I'm gonna just choose tinderbox, and I make a fire. So I'm going to do this. I can choose add to bonfire, which after, and I'll start adding these to bonfire. But right now I'm going to choose knife, and on screen it pops up with fletching and say I want to fletch these. It'll take about 45. It'll give you the estimated time, it'll give you the experience you've gained total from it, and it just becomes an all-around handy thing. So when you re-hit R, it'll come up with this. What you need to do is just click on this right here, change selected tool, and you'll go back to choose a tool. And then say you can go back to adding them to bonfire, which makes it a more versatile screen, but most people didn't know about the change tool most likely, but it can become a very effective thing. It'll tell you how much you make, and I'll show you right here. I'll show you right now. If you do on knife, it'll show you how much the high alchemy value is, the shop price, how much experience you get, and if you have, you have to be, have a fletching level, it shows your requirements and materials. So if the Grand Exchange was on the beta, which it, right now it's not, it would actually show you such things as it'll show you what the Grand Exchange cost would be, so if you'd make or lose money in some cases. So yes, it can become a very interesting thing, and I don't know why I'm leaving this to go, but it's 915, 1000 XP just from fletching there. It's one way you can actually see how much experience per inventory you can actually get, which will come around being a much better influence and showmanship on the game. And when it's done, you just click done, and it's, or it'll go off on its own. So in the next part, I will show you power mining, power dropping, high alchemy, and one more thing, superheating. And we're back. You might be wondering, where am I? Well, with this giant rock creature, you kind of get the feeling I'm in the Living Rock Caverns. In my inventory, I've got 8 coal and 8 gold. I also have some nature runes and a lava battle staff on my back. A nice, sexy, new-looking battle staff. All right, and you see, you can just speed drop now with GGG, or just press and hold it. Well, it'll keep doing that. And you can do the same with such things as, like, gold, and just, you'll keep mining as you drop. And apparently I don't have any left, it says, but I know I've got gold. and you'll drop it as you keep mining. So, that aside, I want to just go on ahead to the next thing. You can superheat, and you can just drag the bar over, and boom, drop it after you superheat it. So, X, boom, C. X. And see, it goes that fast. This making mining one of the undervalued skills, or one of the last skills people even want to do, because of it's a slow skill, to be honest. And it'll still be slow, but it'll be more tolerable. And before I forgot, you could wear your goldsmithing gauntlets and such for the bars, and use that and get some free, smithing experience. And not to mention that you can do high alchemy the same way. And it's better to use noted, of course, for this, but you'll still high alchemy at a good rate. And this would be good for those who want the high alch to 99 still in magic, so it's a lovely thing to do. And I still have a couple more things to go over, and I'll see you with those parts right now. Alright, and we're back with this next part, and hi Papa Mambo! Okay, that aside, you see the common Jadinkos, and this works with every kind of trap in the game so far, other than the ones that you set up, use the teasing stick with, those that you have to set up to prop up the rock, and such. So any trap that you actually have in your inventory that you have to click and it'll lay it, so you can just literally just do this. It'll lay it on its own. Boom. Boom. And just do that over and over. So, I mean, it can do that for all the traps in your inventory. Now, the chance of me catching one right now is very slim to none, but I'll just stand here and wait for one while I keep going over some things. Now, as you know, there's a lot of changes to the EoC because of this, and it can make skilling a lot better, and it makes laying these a lot easier. You still got to click on them to pick them up, of course, and look at them just tearing through all four, tore through three of them. They'll probably go through a couple more in a minute, but that aside, just picking them up, and I mean, you can literally just stand over there, pick them up, walk over, pick them up, and lay it down again. Literally just that quick. And it makes this a whole lot easier. It makes it a whole lot more interesting. And it can make Hunter one of the most boring skills in the game, honestly, into one of the most interesting skills. Well, I wouldn't really say interesting, but it'll make it a more tolerable skill overall. And yay, I caught one. And a Calverberry, okay. But yes, that can make it a whole lot easier. I've got one more part to go over, and I'll go ahead and just tell you what it is. It is crafting, and I will see you back here in just a moment. And we're back in the lovely city of Alcarid after its graphical rework, of course. And I've got blue dragonhide leather in my inventory, and one on my action bar, of course. You might be wondering, why do I have four slots plugged up instead of just say three, or say three or two? And it's because they have added new items to the game, and here's one of them. So click on the action bar ability, and you notice there's now new blue dragonhide shields. It requires four dragonhide, one thread, and of course it requires a level of 72 crafting. It offers about 70 experience more, and it's about 1,000 GP shop price more, and about 2,000 gold more. So let's go ahead and make these out, because I've never made these before either. And they're really nice looking shields. They offer some good defense for, say, rangers, and it'll become a good thing. And see, you make about 6 shields in inventory, and that's not bad at all. So as you can see, this was a skilling video, even though it wasn't really over a lot of skills, but these were the skills that I seen that really got a major improvement after the EoC update. So this is Phonic Arts, and I will see you next time, and enjoy whatever videos I might have on the outro.